evening and welcome to the Highland Hills Middle School 5th and 6th grade spring concert, our final performance of the year. You'll notice on the program, nowhere does it say beginning band. It just says 5th grade. 5th grade band. Our 5th graders are no longer beginners. In fact, you'll be very impressed with what you're about to hear. Most of you have been to every concert. I think you'll hear a big leap from the winter concert, especially from the very beginning of the year. In fact, I'll bet if a complete stranger walked in here during the course of their performance, they would never guess that they're listening to kids that are in their very first year of play. Jerry and I are very proud of our fifth graders. They've come a long way, and to think that back in August, they didn't even know which end of the instrument to blow into. I think they're making some really good music. We're going to start with a piece called School Spirit March. It's out of our book, but there are some new skills in it, new rhythm, dotted quarter eighth notes, and it's just a fun little march. But my apologies in advance if you happen to be a Kentucky basketball fan. Two harmony lines. First, we will hear the clarinets, flute, and oboe on the melody.
Thank you.
pieces that the fifth grade band performed at ISSMA, a district contest at Jeffersonville High School earlier this year. They entered group five, which is the easiest level of music, and there are three judges, three professional music educators serve as judges, and you're critiqued on how well you perform the music. And it's kind of like the Olympics. You can get a gold award, silver award, or bronze, gold of course being the best. Well, the fifth grade band not only got a gold, but their scores from all three judges were high enough that they received what's called a gold with distinction. So Mr. Yankee and I are very proud of our fifth grade band. The first piece we're going to play from contest is Manchester March.
Thank you.
The next piece is going to feature our trumpet section. It's a piece called The Buglers. One thing you also may notice, our percussion section is very busy. As you'll hear, as you've heard so far and throughout the concert, a lot of percussion responsibilities going on. You'll see them running around, just making sure we practice where you play this piece, then you gotta go here, then grab this music and take it over there, but don't leave your drumsticks over there, because then you won't have it for the piece after that. So the percussion have a lot of responsibilities, and those responsibilities become even greater the more they progress through band.
Thank you.
know, I hear them play every day, I hear it on the concert, and it floors me, like I said before, to think that they just started playing at the beginning of this year. Raise your hand if you hear a little bit of an improvement since the first concert. Yes. Mr. Yank and I tell them what to do and how to do it, and this group has really worked very hard. They really take it seriously, and that's very encouraging for looking on to later years. You're sixth grade band, they were fifth graders last year. It's neat for them to kind of watch and see where they were, and in a moment the fifth graders will get to listen to the sixth grade and hear what they'll be doing next year. So Mr. Yank and I like to tell them that there's never a time when you've arrived and there's nothing else to work at. There's nothing harder. We can always raise the bar, and we love it when the kids accept and relish that challenge. That's very exciting for us. Our final piece for the fifth grade band is entitled The Tempest, which is a storm, and it starts out kind of like the calm before the storm, and then you'll hear the storm cut loose. It's a lot of fun, very exciting. The kids really enjoy playing it. The Tempest. Take a couple of minutes to switch groups, and we'll be back with the sixth grade advance.